Hello, I'm David Roger, General Counsel for the Las Vegas Police Protective Association. This is going to be part one of a two-part series concerning qualified immunity and the recent state court decision in MAC. This was handed down just a couple of days ago. The short answer is this. It is not likely to have a great effect on your civil liability in cases in which people charge you with violating their constitutional rights. But it is concerning, and it's something that we are going to have to address with the Nevada State Legislature. And so, let's talk about qualified immunity. And so many of you have heard about it. Qualified immunity is a federal principle that says that unless an officer has violated a clearly established law, the officer shouldn't be held liable for damages. And you know, the key is clearly established law. And then the federal courts, and to a certain extent the state courts, have always recognized that you have a difficult job, you have to make split-second decisions, and you shouldn't really be held responsible for things, for cases, decisions that aren't clear. And so, you know, the courts try to apply a bright line rule. So in federal court, unless the plaintiff can establish that you violated a clearly established law, you are entitled to qualified immunity. So let's talk about the MAC decision. MAC went to visit a friend in the Nevada State Prison. MAC was pulled aside, strip searched, and then denied access. And so MAC filed a case in federal court. And it's important to recall or understand that there are federal causes of action and state causes of action. And so the MAC filed the complaint in federal court. And in the complaint, MAC said that officials had violated his or her, I don't know if MAC was a male or female, but MAC's constitutional rights under both the federal constitution and the state constitution. And so there were federal causes of action and state causes of action. And the federal courts have jurisdiction over both. And so in looking at the case, the federal judge said, well, you know, I don't know if under Nevada law, an individual can sue for violation of civil rights, and two, whether an officer is entitled to qualified immunity. And so the federal judge sent it to the Nevada Supreme Court and said, hey, can you decide these two issues? And the Nevada Supreme Court said, yes, an officer can be sued for violating civil rights under Nevada state law. And two, the state legislature has not provided for qualified immunity for officers. And so under Nevada law, because there is no statute that gives officers qualified immunity, the Nevada Supreme Court said that federal court, the Nevada statute does not provide for qualified immunity. Therefore, officers who violate a person's constitutional rights are not entitled to qualified immunity. And so this is an issue that we will have to address with the legislature. It is probably not the end of the world today, as we will explain in part two, but it is another setback for law enforcement. As always, thank you very much for contacting me with your questions. If you have any other issues, please contact me at droger@lvppa.com. Thank you.